Microsoft. I work for the new Microsoft. And actually, there is John on there. He also works for the new Microsoft. He's creator of a Lodash library. So yeah, we are doing open source at Microsoft, which is pretty cool. I work on the Microsoft Azure Management Portal, which is one of the largest single-page applications in the world. It's for sure the largest one written in TypeScript. There is something around 500 developers working on that. Encourage you to check it out. You can get a free 200 bucks to spend on Azure just to try it out. You can, you know, try it out like VM with 8 cores and 32 gigs of RAM to play around with Visual Studio all for free. So why not? I have a blog, jj09.net. Encourage you to check it out and subscribe. You can find there more information about me. I'm also a biker. You know, here I'm at the Mount Evans in Colorado. This is the highest paved road in North America, 40,000 feet. And the oxygen level at the top is 50% of what we have here. So that was pretty cool. And you know, then I moved to Seattle, and here I'm doing the largest bike ride in America, the Seattle to Portland. Every year, 10,000 cyclists is doing this 200 miles in one day or two from Seattle to Portland. It's super cool. And Seattle is, and Portland are great places for cyclists. So it's, if one of you are a cyclist, move to these cities. So I want to show you the next JavaScript framework. How many of you know more than two JavaScript frameworks? Okay, almost everybody. More than three. More than four. Five. Six. Oh, wow. I always look to four, but never to six. Fair respect. So, you know, the problem with frameworks, there's a lot of them, you don't know which one to choose. But the good thing is that, you know, at least, you know, like once a year there's the, you know, the hottest one, right? So last year it was Angular, this year there's a hype towards React. But what about the next year? You don't know yet, right? Because it's not next year. But Angular 2 is in preview, and I got pretty excited about it when I first checked it out because it sort of rethinks all the approach we had before. It uses the idea of web components. Angular 2 is using TypeScript, so you can actually write TypeScript 6 or 7 code with types and transpile it to JavaScript. So there's this new trend coming that we are not writing TypeScript 5 anymore. We can just write TypeScript 6 and you can transpile and run it in current browsers, so we don't have to wait for the browsers to upgrade anymore. And it was pretty cool. I was following them, and then I found this guy. Rob Eisenberg. He was working with the Angular 2 team. He's a creator of the Durandal framework, which was pretty popular around 3 years ago, and he wanted to join the forces with Angular. To take the best of Angular and the best of Durandal and create the next generation framework. And he was working with them, but after a while, through some disagreements, he left and he created his own framework called Aurelia. And you know, I had mixed up feelings about it because now we will have again, instead of one source of truth, we'll have two and we'll have to choose. But I would like to say that Aurelia is the new Angular. Because a lot of people know about Angular 2 because of Angular 1, right? But Aurelia is like something pretty new. But actually, Aurelia is what Angular 2 is supposed to be. But because of reasons, it's not. So Aurelia is using ECMAScript 7. So you can write ECMAScript 7 code. They're using Bubble Transpiler to transpile it to ECMAScript 5, so you can run it in current browsers. They're using npm for package management, and also JSPM, which is a package manager for ECMAScript 6. This is using system.js, the ECMAScript 6 module loader, so you don't need to require JS anymore. You can and just use ES6, and later on, after the browsers will implement that, you'll not need the external libraries for that. And they also use Gulp for automation, which makes, you know, development experience very, very nice. So instead of talking about this, I'll jump out and try some code. So it's pretty good on the internet, but let's see working it. So open up my console. You guys can see it. Okay, so here, actually, you know, if I had internet, I would go to Aurelia.io website. Probably I won't be able. So, you know, on Aurelia.io, you can find a link to project named Skeleton Navigation. This is like file and project for Aurelia. And I already downloaded this in Thunder. Skeleton Navigation. And I already did npm install on that and jspm install. So open Sublime, all of this. And this is a like final project. I just removed the source folder with my source file, so I'm just, you know, starting from scratch. You see, you know, a lot of files here, but there's a lot of automation already built on, and they're all even the sample tests. So they're showing you how you can write tests. Because you know, always when you start with the new framework, you're trying to figure out where to put things, how to structure the code, how to do this, do that. So here you have pretty nice experience with that. So starting from index.html, so this is a starting file. Nothing interesting in header, so I'll just hide it. And here in body, you have this Aurelia app. So this is saying that okay, here will be my Aurelia app. And actually, if I can remove that by coincidence, actually, this is what is by default. So I'm saying that, you know, my configuration file will be in main.js directory, main.js file. Because Aurelia is using conventional configuration, so you don't need to write a lot of boilerplate code. Just use conventions. And of course, you can customize where you want. So here I have the splash screen, so this is what will be visible when the actual app is loading. And here is app bootstrapping. So here I am importing system.js, my library to module loading, and config.js. So in config.js, I'm just saying that I'm using Babel transpiler, here's some options, here I'm configuring paths, and here my packages where my packet is living, and this is pretty much what is in this file. So going back here, and here I am running Aurelia Bootstrapper, and I am kicking off the app. So you know, if I run it now, it will just display this because I don't have enough any files. And one more thing, so here's a Gulp file. You guys know Gulp? How many people know Gulp? Okay, everybody knows Gulp, so great. So here, actually, you know, Gulp file is pretty empty. Everything is in build directory. And here you can look at the tasks. For example, here I have my watch task, which is watching files for change, and on change is running the build. And here I have a build task. It's nicely divided. So you know, if you're interested, you can dig in. You can adjust it to your needs. But for now, if I just go back to my console and do Gulp watch, should transpile all my files from source to this directory. And it should be able to run a couple of 9,000. And come on. Starting server. Oh, maybe because I don't have anything in source there. Watch. But you know, for now, he wants nothing more than the just the index file with anything. So let me start by adding the configuration file. This main.js, hopefully will work out to that. So main.js, and in main.js, we only need one function, export function configure, with one parameter. I will call it parameter Aurelia, because this is basically what we'll pass here. Configure. In my configure function, I can configure how I want to run this framework. But for now, I'll just say Aurelia use standard configuration. And I'll say Aurelia start. And then next set root. So here I need to set my starting web component because Aurelia is using web components. So here I need to provide the name of my starting web component. I can say app. So I have to create a web component called app, or I can leave it empty, and then by default it will be also app. So I don't have to do this. See if Google. Oh yeah, something happened. Finally, great. So I refresh it now. Now I'm getting console errors. That's fine because you see here I don't have app.js file. So the first step I need to create app.js and app.html because the web components has its view in HTML file and the view model in JS file. So I'll create a simple web component. Say app.js and I'll just say export class app. I'll just leave it empty. So this is ECMAScript 6 class. And I'll create the view app.html. Say template. Because Aurelia is, you know, conforming to HTML5 spec, and HTML5 spec is saying yeah, web components needs to be inside the template tag. Here I'll just say hello Aurelia. Aurelia. Save. And I go back to the browser. What is this? Refresh. And we have it. Okay, so it looks like my book is not cooperating. We run it one more time. Maybe HTML, so just copy my HTML to this because this is the directory that Aurelia is actually using. Okay, and serving, so I should refresh that. And I have hello Aurelia here. So I have the starting point. And actually, you know, if you don't really do any particular configuration in my main.js file, you don't need this file. In index, you can just remove this. Say just Aurelia app, and again by convention, Aurelia will assume that your app is living in app.js file. So I will just change this. I'll remove my main.js file. So I'll delete this and delete that. It's gone. And here I have still my hello Aurelia working, right? So this is that was the minimum I need to get started. So now I'm displaying the static text. Let's bind something to view model. So on view model, I'll create two properties. First name, so my name, and full last name. Okay, this is a JavaScript 6 class properties. And in my view, I'll say hello first name and last name. Who knows how I bind the view model in Aurelia? Anybody? I'll surprise you, you don't have to do nothing. It's already done. And this is great. If you go here, you see there's my first name and last name. And you know, everything is happening by the convention. I don't need to set my first and last name to some scope, use the scope, then apply controller to my view. Nope. Just create a property on it, class, and by convention, it will be binded to your view. So let's do something more. I'll have my first and last name here. I'll create an input tag so I can edit it. And you know, in input tag, when you want to set the value, just say value, for example, Jacob, right? But if you want to bind the variable to value, you just say in Aurelia, you just say value.bind and you provide the name of the variable. I'll do the same for last name. I'll click save. Go back here. I have my input tags, and you see I am editing this, and it binds automatically. I can concatenate this. I can say get full name return this first name, this last name. This is a ECMAScript 6 template, string template. You know, this is actually equivalent if I said this first name plus quote plus this last name, but this is a more cleaner. I like this approach more. Now, in my view, I can say just full name. Go back to browser, and still my full name is automatically refreshed. What I want to do now, I want to create a simple CRUD app, and I will be able to, you know, I'll create a button, create, which will have the names in the list, will display it, and we'll be able to remove them and edit them. So the first step is I need to, on my view model, I'll create a list of names. I'll say names, this empty array, and I'll create a create function. In my create function, I'll just say this names, push, and I'll just take the full name for simplicity. I could also create a, you know, a personal object, have this object to the list and then parse it. But just for now, I'll just have the full name. And in my view, here I'll create a button called create. And here I'll say button click dot trigger equals create. Now, it's pretty cool because it responds like English, like button, click, trigger, create, function. So, this is adding, but I will also need to display it. So here I'll add some HR tag, here I'll say H1 names. Here I'll create a list, I'll iterate over, and I will say repeat this tag for name of names. This of is a ECMAScript 6 syntax for looping over functions, because if you say name in, then it the name is set to the key, but if you say of, the name is set to the value, which is what we usually want when we are looping over. And here I'll just say name, save it, go back to the browser, close the console, let's say create, boom, it's me. And Rob Eisenberg, say create. So I have added the list working. So now I want to be able to remove the items. So I'll add the button delete next to the names. So here I'll create a button and I will say delete. I'll also say again click dot trigger equals delete. But actually here I need to say $parent delete. Because here I am, you know, looking and sort of in the scope of for, so you know the parent template language is requiring you to use the parent that you're accessing the view model, not the scope of the loop. And here in delete, you know, I can pass the name and then, you know, do the lookup in the array on which index the name is, or I can say $index, and Aurelia will find this index for me. So I'll do this. And I'll create the delete function here. Say index. And I'll say this names splice index 1. This is removing one element from the array. So go back to my names. I'll say create. I'll say delete. Disappears. Let's add more. Boom. Okay. So now I can add and delete elements. So the last thing is editing, right? So this will be a little bit more complex, because what I want, to have like edit button here, and when I click edit, I would like my static text to become the input tag, and then I don't want edit button again, I want like save button, so if I click save, it will update. So to do that, I'll create my edit function. function here. And I will take the index as a parameter. And here I'll say this editing equals index. So I'll know which element is being edited. And in my view, I'll create another button, say click the trigger equals rmEdit index, call it edit, and also create another button, save, say save here.
Does Aurelia have a way to make these, if you don't speed up, you're not creating any?
Sorry.
Is there a way to make events delegate so you don't have to repeat the bindings for every single element in your list?
Repeat the bindings for every single element.
So if there's 20 items in your list, I assume you're going to have 60 events that are wired up under the covers. Is there a way to just have to be 3 events on each?
Oh, yeah. I mean, I could reuse this event. That's not a problem. That's my choice. I could copy paste. Yeah, that's you know, totally up to you. And for now, I'll just use this because what I want to show is that here I'll say show dot bind equals to parent dot editing different than index. So show me this button only if this element is not being edited. And then I'll copy paste this and paste it here. I'll say if this index is editing, show me save button. So let's see if this works. Add this, press edit, and this change the save button. Of course, you can reuse it, just change the label and do the logic. I just choose to do it like that. And also, you know, if I click save, I want to go back to editing. I want to kind of finish editing, so I just create this, say save, and I'll say editing and find. But also, what I want when I start editing, I'll create a new temp value. And I will assign the name to my temp value, which I will bind to my input tag. And on save, I'll do opposite. So I'll say this name, so index, give me the temporary value. And here, in order to, I'll create span tag and say again show the bind. And actually, I'll copy this. This is not edited. Just please. Show me the static text, but if it is, so I'll just copy and paste. I'll refactor later on. For now, I'm just doing how to get it working. So value.bind equals parent and to bind parent. And let's see if it works. Go back here, say create. Ooh, say I think at the beginning. It's not good.
You bind shift by the lines.
Oh, yeah. Show bind, show bind. Okay. It's different. And this is okay. Let's see. Ooh, okay. Click edit. This and click save and I drop Alexander create and edit it. See the rope save. I can steal the items as well. So, you know, what is cool? Refactor this. Like, for example, I can take the input tag here and then I can get rid of this. I need to create a separate span for this. I can get this edit in here. I can get rid of this in here. So, you know, my entire container will be in here. I'll grab this in here. And I will get the show bind on the span tag. I can also, you know, bind it to only one action. I can, you know, create the same button with only single button and just change the label up dynamically. Totally, up to you how you do it. But what is, you know, really cool, you know, here I have only 27 lines of code, and all of this code is just vanilla JavaScript. There is like no framework specific code, so So, you know, this can be, you know, reused for whatever you want. The only kind of specific code is in the view. So I think this is pretty cool. And, you know, like the problem with JavaScript frameworks is that, you know, you're applying for a job and, hey, do you know AngularJS? And do you have like 5 years of experience with it? Because we need senior engineer who can effectively lead the project. And, you know, next year this will happen with React. Sorry, you need to have 2 years of experience with React. It doesn't matter that, you know, actually Ward heard about React last year, right? And, you know, the learning curve, for example, in React, in my opinion, is pretty steep. You know, you need to learn a lot of things to get started. But in Aurelia, it's pretty not very steep, I would say. You know, the basic things are very easy. You do more complex things. Start, of course, with more complex, but here it's, you know, so simple, and to start doing things and, you know, writing, especially writing just JavaScript, is very, you know, vanilla JavaScript. So if you know JavaScript, you know ECMAScript 6 or 7, you can start writing this code. And the Aurelia documentation, if I don't have internet, oh yeah, I have internet, right? So, you know, docs are pretty cool. So, for example, when I was doing use standard configure your function, and here a chapter on configuration, what you can do here, and actually you can, you know, we can even search for, I use this use standard configuration at the beginning. If I find this function, you can see that here, fetch pointer, use standard configuration. You can, you know, diving into this code, you can see what's going on. Everything is, of course, open source, everything is on GitHub. What is cool about Aurelia is componentized. So, you know, if you look at the GitHub repo, somewhere here, forecast, the repo, you see that, for example, framework is only part of the code. Like, for example, router is separate library. The same with like history, I believe, and the same with HTTP client, for example. So all this is like simple components that you can use, but you don't have to. The core is a framework. Okay, so I just showed the binding, but I'm going to show more single page app things. So for example, routing, like usually in single page app, you want to have multiple pages and change them without reloading page. So how to do this? So for now, I'll just move all my names logic app logic to new view. I'll call it names JS. I'll just rename the class to names. I'll do the same with the view. I'll just copy this. Call names.html and paste this, and I'll just close them. And here I'll remove everything, and I'll just create one function called configure and router. And the first part is config, and second is router. And this function I'll just say router because it will be injected here. In my config, I'll say map and provide array of my routes. So my first route, my only route for now, will be empty string because it's my default route, and I want to use module ID names. Save this. In my view, I'll remove everything. I'll just say router view. I'll save this. Back to my localhost. Doesn't work. Let's see why. You might specify a route pattern, router config. Let it run. Oh, route and router. And you know, I have my names, view component displayed by default. but you know, usually you want to have more than one. So I'll create one more, I'll call it about HTML. You know, this create template, I'll just say this is about page. Also need to create a view model for that. Say about oops. About.js. And here I'll just create export class about empty class because I'm having empty. And my app, I'll create another route called about. And I'll use module about. I'll go back to the browser. And now if I say pound about. Oops, already loaded, and this is the about page, and if I see nothing, I'm in my name's page. Never display your routes. What you can do, you can add in the route, you can set nav param to true. I'll do the same for about to have them both. And I also will add the extra param called title. I'll call it names and say title. About. And in my view, let's see, I have map here, menu, you all click and repeat the for calls route of router dot navigation, because this is where Aurelia is putting the routes. If you say map true, and here I will create a link. And, you know, again, I want to bind to href. Property, so I just say href.bind and use route.href, and here I say route.title, the property I created. The href is there by default. So let's say that. Go back to the browser. Here, and I have my routes, names, and names, and the about, and the about. So this is, you know, simple routing, pretty straightforward. Of course, you need to know a few things. The very common thing you do when you use front-end JavaScript framework, you want to be able to call the API. So Aurelia has the HTTP client, and I'll create a new view component called GitHub, and I'll just download the repos. List of my repos from GitHub, or if I have internet, you can more. So I would say github.js, create a class GitHub. And here I need to get the HTTP client, and I can get it by injecting it into my class. And in order to do that, I need to import the inject decorator from our framework, and also I can import HTTP client from Aurelia HTTP client, and now I can use decorator here saying inject HTTP client, and here I create a constructor with one parameter, I'll call it HTTP. And you know, this module will be injected as the first parameter in my constructor. So it's like, you know, dependency injection container for free. So I install this constructor. Okay, and I'll say this HTTP equals HTTP. And Aurelia also have this activate function. And this function, when you implement it, will be executed before the DOM rendering. Because, you know, usually you don't want to render, you know, an empty DOM and then render it again after you call it down. So it will wait until the activate is done. And here I'll say return this HTTP get. And here I need to have my link, so just see, let's see, I just API GitHub.
So
that you
return prompts, is that okay?
Yes, yes, do. So here, you guys know that Microsoft has almost 300 repos on GitHub. But
at the codeplex.
I don't know, I don't work there. The thing is, I had issues with pagination. I was on Twitter with this one guy just before the the talk, I asked them how can I get more than first 30, so we use pagination, but I cannot fetch all of them, so I can only fetch 100. So for now, we'll just get the 100 of them. I think that's what I have to do. I don't need page, just 100. This should return the 100 repos. See? Yeah, okay. Seems good. So I'll paste this here. Let me reformat this. And then here I say then, promise, as it gets properly. And I say response. I can use error function, which is pretty cool. And here I'll say this repos. So I'll set my response content to my repos. And then in my view, which I didn't create yet, say GitHub HTML template Microsoft repos. And here I'll say UL ready, repeat the form repo of repos. And here I'll create an anchor tag href.find repo dot. I think it was HTML URL. HTML URL. So this will be linked to my repo and repo.name. Save. And I'll also add this to my routes. So here, and I'll say GitHub. And go back to my Aurelia. Okay, I have GitHub here. I'll break it. And download the first 100 MS repos from XML URI. But what is cool, and because you know, in order to get all 300 names to separate requests, and what this is actually a feature of the Babel compiler, you can use the promises without external library, like few promises here. So if I go here and I say, I think that was, I have this code somewhere. You probably just want to watch type it. Get back under MS repos. Yes, here it is. So I'll just copy this paste. So I'm running out of time, I guess. Boom. So then doing here, I'm using the promise library, and I will be waiting until all three calls are done. So I'm calling this URL, and I'm calling the page 0, 1, and 2. And after the response, I'm setting this to array, and after everything is done, then I'm just concatenating these three arrays to my results. So let's see if this worked. With GitHub, I've already executed this, and now you can see there's all 280 repos, I think. And the link should work as well. So that was calling API, and the very last thing I want to show you is how to create a custom web components with Aurelia. Because you know, sometimes you want to put something somewhere on the page and reuse it easily. That was pretty hard in it is pretty hard in current JS frameworks. So for example, here I have this menu. So I would like to create a web component out of this menu. So I'll just hit this, I'll create a new file called menu.html. Say template. I'll paste it here. And I'll also create menu.js. Here I create export class menu. And for now, I'll just leave it empty. And in my app.html, I'll say require from menu. And here I'll say menu. Just like that, without doing anything, I just need to get the model. I'll click save. And I have menu, but I don't have my routes. But because the web component doesn't know anything about the router, because router is sitting in the app, so I need to pass the router to my menu. And you can do it easily. If I go to menu and I say app bindable router, set by default to null, and I also need to import bindable from Aurelia framework. And in here, I need to say router.bind equals router. Because I already have a router in my app.js, right? Here I have my router. So I'm just, you know, injecting this variable into the menu component. So here, and now I have my names. And you know, you can inject whatever. You can, you know, for example, create a component name, and you can inject first and last name, and you can reuse it all across. Like, you know, I can just grab this view, and I can say, okay, my about page, actually, what I want to do, I want to put this also at the bottom. So, you know, now if you go to the about page, you have menu here, and you have menu here. Oh yeah, because I don't have router on my about page, so it didn't get injected. But you know, that's the idea. Please check out the Aurelia.io website. It's pretty neat, it's pretty clean. Here you have you can get started page. What we have is you have npm installed, you have jspm installed, which can be installed by npm. Then you can download this navigation skeleton project here. So you know you can click here, go to GitHub, and here's the project. Let's see here. Okay. So here's a repo. You can just do git clone, and you'll get the starting point I had at the beginning. You just do Google Watch, you can start developing, and everything should work. So Aurelia.io, if you want some more deep overview of Aurelia, there is a very cool Pluralsight course by Scott Allen with applications with Aurelia. There should be more stuff coming because the framework is getting more and more popular. The last conference in Atlanta, I met people who are already using Aurelia in production, which is a little bit crazy because it's an alpha stage. They should get to beta by the end of the year. Hopefully version 1 sometime next year. But you know, they said that you know we rather take the risk and use Aurelia to write, you know, less code, to don't spend time investing in learning another framework just to use it because we need to release by the end of next year. So they have hoped that by the end of the next year Aurelia will be released. If not, they'll just go with alpha. If everything works, it's fine. And if you want to learn ECMAScript 2015 or ECMAScript 6 bubble.js.io website, there's a pretty nice overview of it. It's just like, you know, the feature and short overview, like why you should care and how this is making JavaScript better. So I encourage you to check it out. So thank you very much. Here are the Aurelia stickers. If you want them, it's from Rob. He sent it to me so you can grab it and stick to your laptop. And thank you very much. Thank you.